days, my wife cycles late. Gotta bring a little soldier into this world to hate. Gotta teach him to be great, gotta teach him to have faith. I was born a king, I'ma die a king. I strive for knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. Gotta walk a righteous path, anger and wrath only equals nuclear aftermath. You got that? I hope so. It's CIA that be flipping all this dope, yo. Money is power and power turns to greed. Then greed corrupts absolutely.
Freedom. This is the time for revolution. Bring out the scrolls and read them. Look to yourself for the solution. This is the sound of freedom. This is the sound of revolution. Bring out your souls as free men. Look to Jah for the true solution.
Freedom's here to stay, it out the way.
The queen has come. I can feel the king's arrival with the rising of the sun. And justice is mine. For her children, she will sound the battle cry. We don't die. Children of the Most High, equality will reign, beaten down like Samoan sugar cane. Say, I, and I, he is a burning and a shining light. You shall be willing for a season to reign in Jah light.
Unto Zion we fly, but unto Zion we go. Our prayer and dream, unto Zion we fly. Oh, to the land of righteousness, off we fly.
Zion. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yes, Oroville, you're listening to UBME, board member of KROV. Yes, that's right. Been here since, I don't even know, 2 years or so. I want to give thanks to Lion and Judah Society, to Discipleship Radio, and Game Amp, and all the other partners who've been helping us make it happen since Block Market September 2015 or 14. I don't know. Gotta look at the social network. Look it up, Game Amp on Facebook. Like us and give thanks to Jah Rastafari. You're listening to Seen a Soul, and just again, just giving praises to all of my counselors and ones who've helped grow me up in the land of enchantment so we can be here in the 530 making it happen for community enrichment and education in the name of His Majesty, yes, and Yeshua HaMashiach, that's right, and yes, Q Play. Community enrichment. And don't forget Block History 227-2016 TBA for the location.
No se llora, amor, nada más. Llora, no se llora.
Yes, yes, yes. Soon come. Yes, I. Feasting with Lion of Judah Society. Lion of Judah Society Espanol. Rastafari Midrashim and more. Listening to Sina Soul of the 505 Bernalillo County, New Mexico, Nueva Mexico, but she's from the Samoan Islands and Cuba. Talk about humanity. And that one is a blessed sound that we love. They're not going to put us on the res. No, we were reserved for Yeshua Ha Mashiach. So I want to give thanks and praises. I want to welcome I and I brethren here who are at the studio with I and I. On mic two, we have Brother Alonso from Lion of Judah, or Rastafari Fellowship 2, Lion of Judah Espanol, and he's a blessed artist, and just want to say, and he's been helping us out for months, actually for a whole year. This is a whole cycle, one whole year from Block History 2015. And on mic three, we have Brother Ison from Rastafari Midrashim and Discipleship Radio, and just the phenomenal brethren. I want to give them thanks and want to welcome them in here to Caduce culture And I want to thank our father, Abba Kaddus, and the family for listening in, and the Holy Spirit, and Yeshua HaMashiach. So, brethren, greetings.
Greetings. Greetings, Orville. Greetings, KROV 91.1 FM listeners. And I, Wyndham, your brother, Ison, in Christ, greet you in the name of the King of Kings, Kenamali Haile Selassie, Christ in kingly character, in the faith of Jesus Christos, Jesus Christ. And I give thanks for this time to speak with the audience, and may all be well this evening.
Yes, hi, brother. I just want to thank you, first and foremost, you and Lion of Judah Society, for just all your blessings and help throughout this year, especially with your writings and your graphic design and a lot of the in-kind donation and financial support that you've made towards this radio station and Wee Wee Someday Kaddus Culture and all of our other projects throughout the year. So, and also, let me just give thanks, have say what's up to Brother Alonso. Would you like to please bless us up?
All right, shalom. I'm a little bit shy. This is kind of weird, so, you know. Yes, give I some time to loosen up and stuff like that. Now, yes. We appreciate the opportunity to be here and speak before the public that we know is well tuned in and as well should be to KROV 91.1 FM Oroville Community Radio Radio Comunidad.
Yes, I want to thank you for all the love and support you've been doing on your channel. And can you name the channels? And, you know, because I get all fumbled and I get nervous and I get all weird, you know, with the accents. So would you kindly gear ones towards, like, you know, the ICE ministries and what the I does, Brother Alonso Tafare, who's a beautiful artist, yes, I, and has been amazing. Just a blessing to our family here.
Just the common resources out there in the internet that we utilize, you know, the basics, you know, the YouTubes and the Facebooks and stuff like that. No doubt it could be used for wrong, but I and I choose to do slightly better things with it. So, and it's not limited to, because once something's uploaded online, you know, it's pretty much it's up for grabs. And we testify to the fact that, you know, days later you could find that same link on some Chinese network somehow, mm-hmm. like all the way across the world, and it's nothing new, you know. You know, we YouTube's, Facebook's, and RastafariFoundation.com, you know. But from there, you know, it's no telling where, you know, where the uploads end up.
Yes, I will. I want to again thank you both, brethren. Please come in and we're just kind of going in with the spirit and just kind of like listening in. I just sitting here as a Rastafari and looking at these changes in the community and things that are in transition, and looking at Block History 2016 Reloaded. And I want to thank you, Brother Ison, for helping us out with the project on the internet and the flyers, which is so beautiful. Can you kind of expound on that beautiful artwork piece and, you know, give ones and ones a little history on you, your channel, and what you do, and you know, where ones can find information on, you know.
Sure. Thank you, sister. And, well, I write for a blog post on WordPress, and it's searchable. You could put it in whatever search engine or Google, Rastafari Talmud. It's TALMUD, very much like the Judaic Talmud. However, it's based on the teaching of His Majesty Haile Selassie I, the conquering lion of the tribe of Judah, and Talmud Talmudit. In the Hebrew language, actually, just means teaching. Now, myself, just to give our listeners a little, you know, background so they could understand me a little bit more and what I'm talking about is that, you know, all my life, I've been through things and things, you know, ups and downs. Just like every other person, every other human being, you know, in this world. And the whole time I was always searching for something that is both inside of myself, but also put in there by the Almighty Creator. Now, through that search, I've gone through many experiences, and it wasn't probably till, you know, I looked into the claims of His Majesty, which directed us to the Holy Bible. Now, of course, we have many interpretations due either to, you know, error, ignorance, envy, greed, any one of those things that we fall prey to, having human nature. So recognizing His Majesty and who He is, and looking in the Bible and seeing and really seeking for myself, I saw that He is God the Father, as Christ, Jesus, Yeshua, Jesus is Christ the Son. And not to get too far or too, you know, theological about those points right there, but, you know, if we're able to discern and break our mind free from the religious spiritual bondage. Now, religion and spirituality, I'm not saying there's anything wrong with that, but many times we're programmed by doctrines of ones that have an agenda, you know, and it's probably not there. They don't even know where the agenda is coming from, but you know, it's coming from a lower drive usually, and it's for ones and ones to discern where that drive is coming from. But nonetheless, you know, as I began writing the blog, it's really it's a journey. It's a journal in my studies, learning to seek and understand the hand of the Almighty, or God, or High Elohim in creation, and how that actually affects not only all of humanity, but also in my own life. So it's really, you know, a personal walk. My faith is personal, though, of course, like projects like, you know, Black History, KROV, Sister Emmanuel's play, the Common Unity, Enrichment Education. These are all in the teachings of the King of Kings, but all things to be done decently and in good order, as the Bible teaches us. As the Bible also teaches us good principles that could be applied practically. So loving our brothers and sisters, you know, we just, amongst the family of the Lion of Judah Society, you know, we just like to, you know, help for the betterment, when ones and ones, or brothers and sisters, you know, have something that they would like to work towards that would benefit to the overall well-being of the community. However, you know, my own personal calling is not so much these type of things. Mine is more so to learn the word and to learn
the law, the law, the Torah. You're in the law, and then you're really prolific with that. Yes, you know, you have great skills and stuff with writing, and you're in the Torah, definitely. And Preacher loved that you're by the book. And, you know, ones who don't know Rastafari, they, you know, Alonso, do you want to say something and add to an additional word to that in this liberty, this beautiful liberty, this humbling liberty of being an ambassador, a child of Abba Kadus, Haile Selassie, and a teacher, and a student, and, you know, just and a bride, you know, in the spirit of things. Yes, you know, the bride of Christ, as we all are.
Well, I'd like for everyone to know that within each and every one of us, there's a possibility that we may resurrect that which is anointed, holy, and sacred. It really doesn't matter. Background, environment, relations, you know, genes so much, history. you know, all that's done away with in faith, because faith is that substance of things not seen, I mean, of things hoped for, and the evidence of things. How does that go, Wendem?
Everything's things not seen. It's things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen.
And the substance.
Of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen.
That's horrible.
No, I'm terrible at that. No, there's a Bible right there. Let me grab it. I could just...
No, she said that's correct.
No,
is it correct? Oh, good, thanks. I think something seems right.
No, but faith, you know what? That's important that happens, because it just makes it, yes, it makes it real. Because unlike... Watch, this is one thing that I really love about teaching, because yes, believe it or not, I teach, right?
We all, yeah.
But it just confirms the fact that I teach in the spirit. It's not because I went to school, it's not because I know anything, it's because I've just been graced in mercy, and I've been touched in such a way that I've received things that to the rest of the world are concealed.
Mm-hmm.
But to whom Jah will, then they be revealed. And so, you know, every time I'm teaching, and I do teach, not only in English, but internationally, and to a very broad audience, you know, across the whole world, you know, hard as that may sound to believe, it is what it is, and you know,
give thanks
to
Father.
I need not validation from anyone else, you know, you know, the Almighty, the heavens and earth, and many, many, many individuals as my witnesses that I do speak truth. Whenever I'm teaching and I can't remember a verse, I give thanks to the Most High, because it reminds me that I'm not one of those people that have learned the way to confuse you, the way to manipulate you, the way to do what is not holy with ones. I'm not that. I don't know the Bible verses. Mm-hmm. I don't have everything memorized, you know.
But it's in the heart.
But it's because it's
in the heart.
It's
and
real.
Then, yeah, and you know, you did say conceive.
Yeah, I don't practice all night to make sure I get this speech well done and convince everyone to go against what their instinct is already telling them. So, you know, so it is very important to be humbled in such a way.
But thank goodness for these technological tools, because here it says Hebrews 11:1. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for. And the evidence of things not seen.
It says, "Imnet imnet esfa, slimenatertiwa neker yemiyasik regete, yemanau yawinam neker yemiyasereta neu." So.
And I said it wrong. I said, "No, faith is the substance of things hoped for, comma the evidence of things not seen." Yes, I.
And so, I was trying to go forward to make a point, you know, somewhere along the line, got distracted. But I wanted that everyone should know that everyone is just as divine in nature as is the Son of the Divine, God Almighty, Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christo, Jesus Christ, you know. And even if ones don't accept him to be who he be, I still hear testify that he still is who he is, and he cannot deny himself, for he is, will be, and always has been. But, and so I'm not expecting everyone to receive that. His Majesty, and our Father, Haile Selassie I, King of Kings of Ethiopia, is in fact the Father. And I even don't require anyone to believe that, because it is, and nothing can ever change that. But I do want ones to know that even though they be who they be, and ones may not receive, that doesn't change the fact that the same Creator created us all. So maybe the relationship may not be in faith and personal, as in our case, but that does not mean that ones that are still a part of this human community, common unity, are not equally as divine in nature and should be treated with the most delicacy.
Mm-hmm.
Because we are all created beings from the Almighty Creator that is good, and He creates a good thing. And the reason I'm going forward to this is because, you know, for some reason, Orville seems to have this kind of like negative you know, like vibe to it. Not that it's a vibration, but other people, including some of us that inhabit the area, mm-hmm. have been taught or fooled into pretending or assuming, mm-hmm. or just making believe that Oroville's to be put down or made less for whatever reason. But I just wanted to say that I think Oroville's pretty cool. You know, I'm not mm-hmm. from here. I'm from Southern California. From the San Diego area, Imperial Valley,
yeah.
Border with Mexico. But
you
I just
came up
that,
here yeah, to help us out with
all
this
the people,
project.
You know, like, because you know, people look down on Oroville in some ways. I'm just being real. I'm not. That's not my personal opinion, mm-hmm. but that's not true. I mean, people here are pretty cool. Everyone's pretty chill. Everyone's pretty free to be themselves, and that's okay. We should be able to live with one another. And accept ourselves to be, for whatever crazy others may think we are, so be it. We still created beings of the divine, and we still divine in nature, and so we must learn to love humanity for what it is. And until we can act on the knowledge that God created you just like he created me, for which reason we should not strive, mm-hmm. and we should feel very proud of being who we are, be it the highest up in government or in the highest, most comfortable position, or being the one that has been humbled to the lowest, you know, mm-hmm. Rank in the social standings. We all equal, mm-hmm. actually, to those that are higher up in the social standing of mm. them more is required. They should exactly. serve the ones that have been given less. Mm-hmm. If we've received more, it's so that we can serve those that have been given less. But what I want to express
Not
is that
abused.
Rastafari say that Oroville is a lovely place, and there's a lot of life and creativity, and there's a lot of divinity, and there's a lot of good possibility if one's just accepted to be. You don't have to see anything, but you just, I mean, you could give that a chance. You could give that a try, and you can take part in this common unity in which we grow bigger than we have ever been, the which our environment has so ill prepared us. Mm. School system inferior, but we could learn for ourselves the way to love one another and serve our fellow brothers and sisters within the human community, and really come to a unity, mm-hmm. a common unity in which we uplift a man above the creation and act on that knowledge and love that we see the day when the children laugh at the individual that talks about the stories grandpa would relate mm-hmm. to him of a time when humans would participate in this thing called war. And I see that day in which children laugh at this unbelievable story mm-hmm. in disbelief. Mm. For why would man go to war? Why would man kill man? For man is a divine being in nature, mm. and his divinity cannot be separated from his humanity. Mm-hmm. Thus, we are very delicate, and because of the present system situation, we've all been very badly affected, and no doubt we reflected in our behavior. Mm-hmm. But it's not to say that we evil in nature. We just divine beings, and I God is a zealous God. He's so think about it. We are very delicate beings, just like our God is very zealous. He himself is very delicate and requires all of our love and attention. So likewise, we being born, created of him, require the same. And when we have been refused and rejected that, and you know, and that has been replaced, that attention of love has been replaced with anger, with violence, with all the negative things that this world up to this very day has provided for us, then no doubt we can come to the realization that it's not, that we can look past it and realize that it's not our fault. Mm-hmm. But it's also not our responsibility to blame it on anyone else, but rather to grow from the circumstance and overcome it. Mm-hmm. But in having a clear conscience that, you know, I'm not a bad person, and you're not a bad person either. We just grew up in a bad situation. Mm-hmm. So it gives us an opportunity to equally go forward and just forget about whatever has been, and move forward and come. I welcome all, you know, and this message, you know, made possible by KROV 91.1 and this message.
I'm lying.
91.1 FM, Oroville Community Radio, California. Let me tell you that I could honestly say that at least for many hundreds of miles, if not thousands of miles, this message is not being broadcasted anywhere else. And so we as a people are fortunate to hear this. And Sister Emmanuel, you know, has provided this service for once to get a message that tells you that, you know what, you're not that bad of a person. And you know what? There's people that have faith in you. There's people that trust that you could do good. That you're not as bad as maybe you have pretended yourself to be, or others have told you or forced you to believe or make believe that you are.
Mm-hmm. Everyone.
But because of Sister Emmanuel, ones are hearing this very moment that's not necessarily the case, because there's good in all of us. It's just that we've never been told that that's the case. And because this is the case, then I say come. Come in union to that which is good, because Rastafari say so.
Yes.
And so you can come to a place where you don't have to be burdened with being forced to act or think a certain way, because we are who we are and nothing can change that, and we need nothing outside of ourselves that is not to confirm what we have been, are, and and ever will be.
Mm-hmm.
So you have that comfort in coming into this unity in which you're not required to a fascist standard of being. Because we know, we know that there's abundance in creation for all.
Expression.
Yeah, and we don't fear different.
Yes, I.
And so KROV 91.1 provides this for the common unity. Mm-hmm. But maybe the unity is lacking because of, you know, it always comes with the price. It always comes with the price. But in this case, you know, ones are invited to come in a yoke that is light and that is not burdensome. Ones are invited to come into a place where you're free and you're at liberty to express yourself. A place where it's not going to force you to be what you just can't be. What is. And nothing can ever change that. So we seek not to change ones. And now, block history, you know, all those around the block, come to KROV.
Yes,
and we seek a support, but a support unlike any other. So a support in which you decide the way that you're capable and you're able to support the movement, the progress. So we ain't gonna put a standard, but we allow ones to think for themselves a way to serve the common unity, if ones are in fact willing and able, and so seek to participate in something that has never been offered before. And so all thanks to Sister Emmanuel.
Thanks to
We here at KROV.
Yes, 91.
But if you got money, come bring.
We do. We do seek Jah's donation. And if your heart is moved, we definitely, the Holy Spirit, the Ruach HaKodesh, the Creator, is speaking to you. And just keep us in meditation as change and transition. Some people are uncomfortable in fear, you know, and they operate on a whatever program that's not working. It's a disorder, you know. So the system is in disorder and disarray. So we're here. Let's come and brother together in Him for the focus and for the love and the light. And I want to thank the music in the background and the family and the Holy Spirit. Brother Iason, would you like to say something in addition to this and the message to Orville? Brother Alonso, thank you so much. That was really a beautiful message and a very humble message, and a prayer of conversation with ones who have the ears to hear and the eyes to see. So we need your support for the Q Play Common Unity Enrichment here in Butte County. Thank you. Brother Iason, anything that you'd like to say?
Well, think a brethren said it very well, very much from the heart, you know. Some of our brothers and sisters are very gifted, like Sister Emmanuel and Wyndham Alonso, Brother Alonso, but, you know, speaking very directly from the heart, me being a little bit more of a...
literary person.
Know, the gifts and callings of the Almighty Creator without repentance. So also, you know, along the same note, maybe along practical lines, you know, yeah, everyone is gifted. Everyone is blessed,
okay.
whether one's known or not. And for the human community, as our God, Father, and King in Christ teaches us, you know, to come together, to reason, and to build, but also to be careful on the foundation that we build on. You know, just a little consideration.
Yes, amen. And about the block. History and the humanity. Can you tell us a little bit about yourself and how, you know, Holy Spirit, or not yourself, but how the Holy Spirit's, you know.
Well, I saw the sister, you know, I spoke to her and I saw that she's very, you know, active and motivated in the community, and especially focused on the youth, because, you know, there's a wise saying that goes throughout many cultures, and, you know, wisdom is wisdom and you cannot deny truth. As long as it's within the logic, the word. So, you know, it's always been said that many trees are planted, or let me give an anecdote from my background, my culture, from when my parents ended up over here. From China, you know, they say, like, there was once a fool that was watching a very old wise man planting a tree, but this wise man was, you know, they probably thought he was going to transition into the world to come.
And in other words, sleep, get to his rest in peace.
You know, quote unquote, die.
Mm-hmm.
And so the fool went up to him and said, "Hey, old man, why are you planting this tree? You're never going to be able to sit under it, or even probably see the first leaf." And he said, you know, he basically replied, he said that, you know, one generation plants so that the future generations can enjoy the shade. And, you know, I think that that's basically what I saw in the heart of Sister Emmanuel. So, you know, among also her being among our congregation, you know, that moved me to do the humble service that I'm able to do, to contribute, and also to let people know the true teaching of Christ, proclaimed by His Majesty Kenamawi Haile Selassie in the new name of Rastafari. Look that up in the Bible, the new name, if you get a chance,
mm-hmm.
get the opportunity. But, you know, because we've been tricked and given so many ones that came in the name, and, you know, I just stay scriptural or in the Bible a lot of time. I hope I'm not wearing it.
No, it's beautiful. Yes, I.
But in that spirit, you know, please, you know, look into our claims of His Majesty, Haile Selassie first, and see the way that he walked, what he did for humanity, and recognize the King, Christ, and King character.
Any particular websites, pages that you would...